Do you want to take your home automations to the next level in a matter of just minutes? In this video, I'm going to show you how to harness the power of OpenAI and integrate it into your smart home setup using the very latest language model, GPT-4o, for only just one penny a day. To make this even easier for you to follow along, I've included a YAML configuration in the description, which can be used for you to understand and test some of the automations showcased in this video. Also, if you're as excited as I am about AI and Home Assistant, subscribe to this channel. In the future, I will be diving deeper into the topic to explore what's truly possible with AI integration inside Home Assistant. I have been experimenting with different AI tools for a while, and recently I have came across an Home Assistant integration called OpenAI Conversations. This integration adds a bit of intelligence to my existing automations, making my notification and Alexa announcements a lot more engaging and less repetitive. The AI can analyze the data from various devices and make context-aware decisions. For example, it can be used to provide robot vacuum maintenance updates, send security notifications to my smartphone based on the motion sensor data, even calculate the energy usage based on all the connected devices, as well as suggest outfits for my morning routine based on the current outdoor weather conditions. But that is not everything. There is also a custom integration inside Hacks that will take this implementation even further and allow you to create your very own ChatGPT voice assistant that will allow you to interact with your smart home devices using natural language, making the interactions a lot more intuitive and user-friendly. It can easily turn on multiple devices at the same time. Add YAML automation config straight inside the chat box and provide in-depth information about all the devices in your home. We are going to take a regular static notification and turn it into something more dynamic with the help of ChatGPT. So I have this AI home monitoring automation that takes the value from 5 different motion sensors around my home. And if any of these sensors detects motion when I'm away from home, I'm going to send notification to my mobile application. To make this notification dynamic, we need to add an extra step called conversational process, which we'll call the ChatGPT API. Now the AI will require a little bit of context that you can specify within this text field here, so it understands how to respond appropriately for what you're trying to do. We will store the response inside the response variable called ChatGPT, and that response variable can be used inside our notifications to make the messages dynamic. Now the API will respond with quite a large JSON file, but the actual response that you're looking for lives inside this JSON node. You can also pass the state of your Home Assistant entities to the context, so then AI can use real-time information of your smart home devices to send you a lot more personalized and relevant responses. This next automation runs every week at 6 p.m. and it sends announcements to some of my Alexa devices. Again, we're using the conversational process that calls the ChatGPT API, but as you can see, the text of the context that we have to specify is totally different. And we're also using the state data from the Home Assistant, which is used to tell ChatGPT when is the filter, main, and side brush due for a change. That information is stored against the response variable ChatGPT, which is then used as part of the Alexa announcement. Now, if you're trying to understand what kind of entities you can use, you can go to developer tools and states and search for relevant entities. However, if you were maybe trying to understand what possible, you can also go to settings, devices, specific integration, click on the entities, and here you have all the entities that are exposed by this device.
All right, vacuum enthusiast. Let's break it down so you know when to babysit your trusty Roborock. Here's your vacuum's health report, straight from the cleaning battlefield. Filter change. 145.5 hours. Clock, plenty of time. So kick back and relax. Main brush change. 295.4 hours. Clock. This brush just had a spa day. It's feeling fresh. Side brush change. 190.4 hours. Clock. Still good to go. No need for early retirement. In summary, you're rolling in cleaning goodness with no urgent changes needed yet. But when those hours start getting low, just picture your robot with a tiny wrench.
We can take this even further and move beyond just passing the data to the AI. We can ask it to perform calculations based on some conditional logic. That means that ChatGPT isn't just reporting information, it's analyzing it and making decisions based on the supplier data. The average energy usage automation runs every day and it calculates the average energy consumption for all the devices exposed in this automation. We then ask the AI to calculate the total value for all the values supplied and round the response to zero decimal places. Because we're looking for an average consumption, we then divide this response by the number of days between the two dates. However, the second date is dynamic and represents today. This means that every time we run this automation, we're going to get a very recent result. Finally, this response variable is stored in this ChatGPT variable, which is then sent daily to my phone as a notification. Finally, we have this AI morning routine that runs every day at 9:30. In a step first, we turn on my coffee machine. In a step two, we get the latest weather forecast and we storing it inside this response variable. We use the data from that response variable in this ChatGPT context to get the latest temperature and outside condition. Finally, we're asking the AI to give us recommendations on what should we wear when going outside based on those values supplied. We store the response in the ChatGPT, which is then used in my Alexa announcements every day.
Good morning, sun. It's time to conquer the day. Get ready for a temperature of 7.5 degrees Celsius with a side of cloudy skies, sunny with clouds. Now, let's talk fashion. For your top, grab a cozy long-sleeve shirt or a light sweater to keep those chilly breezes at bay. Layering is your best friend. For the bottom, how about some comfy jeans or warm trousers? They're perfect for this kind of weather and can handle whatever outdoor adventure you have in store. As for shoes, opt for some stylish sneakers or waterproof boots to keep your feet warm and dry. Don't forget a light jacket, just in case those clouds decide to sprinkle a little rain.
It's quite cheap to use this API. You can see here my spending from the 1st to the 9th of December, and I have only managed to spend about 3 pence. Now, when those automations run automatically, there is hardly any spending. It's only on the 9th of December when I was doing a lot of testing, I have managed to get over 1 pence. And on that day, I must have done anything between 15 to 20 API requests. Obviously, the language model will play a big role in the overall costs. Currently, I have been using this GPT-4o Mini, which seems to be very cost efficient. However, there is also this GPT-4o, the latest model that seems to be more advanced. However, for everything I was trying to do up to now, I didn't really have to use it. This language model, it's approximately 5 to 10 times more expensive, so it can cost you around 1 penny per request. So we have seen all these different automations. Let me quickly show you how to get this configured inside Home Assistant. First, you're going to have to create an account on platformopenai.com. Once the account is created, you will have to create a project. Click create project, give it a name and hit create. Next, you're going to have to generate an API key. Once the key is created and assigned to a project, make sure to store this key because you won't be able to see it again. Now we can use that key inside the Home Assistant. We go to Settings, Device and Services, Add Integration, OpenAI Conversations, we paste the API key, hit Submit, and the integration is successfully added. Before you can fully use the integration, you will have to go back to OpenAI account, verify your mobile number and top up some credits. When it comes to configuration, I keep mine pretty basic at this level because majority of my instructions and the context for AI usually lives inside the automation itself. However, this view is very good at specifying the language model and the response size. All my automations currently use the GPT-40 mini. However, in the future, if I'm doing something more complicated, I might have to use the GPT-40 as well as increase the number of tokens, which correlates with the size of the response from the API. If you are only just getting started with this integration, there is a way to enable a debug login that will provide you with extra log messages so you can see the full request that goes into OpenAI as well as the response and any errors. When you disable the login, you'd be able to download the Home Assistant log file. Next, I want to show you how to add ChatGPT voice assistant inside the Home Assistant, which is a significant step up compared to what's already there. This can be done through another integration called Extended OpenAI Conversation, which is a GitHub project maintained by a developer, but it's available to be configured via hacks. But before I show you how to set it up, let me show you the difference between the two. The built-in Home Assistant isn't really intelligent. I mean, you can ask it to switch on and off specific devices, but with something a bit more advanced, it will most likely struggle. Let's ask it about the status of the lights. So it wasn't able to infer my question and it's assuming that the lights is the name of device. However, if you use that question inside the ChatGPT pipeline, you will get the response with all the statuses around the lights in my home. Even though all the devices are exposed to both of these assistants, we can also try and ask it how many devices do I have. And the ChatGPT one will be able to respond with the total number. However, if we go back to the built-in Home Assistant, it couldn't really understand the question. That is also the case with questions that require some form of reasoning. For example, let's say, I'm in a romantic mood, what color of the light should I use for my office light? Again, the built-in Home Assistant doesn't really understand the question and is assuming that I'm trying to control some of the devices. However, if you copy that question inside the ChatGPT assistant, you will get a reasonable response. If you want to enhance the functionality of this pipeline, there is also this template that you can edit as part of the configuration that will allow you to do some extra things, like adding the YAML automation through the voice assistant chat. We can try and replicate that, but first we need to add the YAML function configuration that will allow us to create automations from the voice assistant chat. So here is the code to add automations. We need to copy this YAML configuration, go back to our Hacks Extended OpenAI conversation, click configure, scroll down to the functions, and hit space and paste it here. Let's go back to the ChatGPT conversation and I'm going to ask it to create a very basic automation that will switch on the office light based on the motion being triggered. And I'm going to give it a unique name so I know it has been created by this. So I'm going to send the command. As you can see here, the automation doesn't exist. As soon as I hit yes, I get the prompt that the automation has been created. And the automation has been created here. And if you can see here, the when condition says when office motion sensor detects changes to detected, switch on the nano leaf light panels, which is the light that I use in the office. So the automation has been created successfully. Adding automations via chat is only one of the few capabilities that this integration can do. I'm going to explore more in the future, so if you are very interested, please subscribe to this channel. And now let me show you how to get this configured inside your Home Assistant. You can easily add this integration via hacks. If you don't have it installed, just search on YouTube how to do that. It's fairly straightforward. Hacks, it's basically a community store that allows you to add custom integrations inside your Home Assistant. Once inside the hacks, just search for extended, click on extended OpenAI conversation, and you will have a button in bottom right corner to download the integration. Once downloaded, you might need to restart the Home Assistant, and as soon as that is done, head over to platform, openai.com, go to the API keys, create a new key, give it a name, copy the key, make sure to store it in a safe location as you won't be able to see it again. Go back to the Home Assistant, settings, device and services, add integration, search for extended OpenAI conversations, give the integration a name, paste this key you have created previously, hit submit, and the configuration has been created successfully. Let's check this integration and how it's actually configured. As you can see, it relies on this prompt template, which provides the context for the AI, so it knows how to respond. And in this case, we're asking it to be a smart home manager of our Home Assistant instance, and that I will provide information of smart home along with questions, and you will truthfully answer using information provided in one sentence in everyday language. We're also going through the list of available exposed entities inside the Home Assistant, storing their ID, name, state, etc. However, not all the devices are exposed by default, and you have to expose them yourself. And to check whatever your devices are exposed, we can go to settings, voice assistant, exposed, and here we can click on any individual devices, and as long as they expose via an assist, it means they are exposed for the AI. Next, we have a bit more context on how the AI should behave when interacting with our exposed devices and the AI language model. Again, I'm using GPT-40 Mini, which I think it's more than enough for what we're trying to do here. The ChatGPT is always evolving, so you might want to check the OpenAI webpage for the latest language model. This takes us to the last section of the configuration called functions. It's where we can paste some extra configuration and enable some additional functionality. And as you remember previously in the video, is where we have pasted some code to allow the AI to create Home Assistant automations via chat. You probably want to go through the automation documentation in hacks just to understand how it works, see some examples, and get familiar with all the functions that are available. However, just to add a new function inside the configuration, it's as simple as copying the code and pasting it here inside this function configuration and then hitting submit. I guess that's everything I wanted to show in this video. Pretty cool stuff, right? AI, it's definitely changing the games for our smart homes. I mean, just imagine having a more intelligent, intuitive assistant that can potentially replace your current smart home assistant like Alexa, live locally, and chat with you almost like a real person. If you've got any thoughts, questions, or cool ideas about the whole integration, drop them in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you think. This isn't the last you will see me diving into this topic. I've got plans to explore more AI stuff in the future videos, so stay tuned. Until next time, keep your home smart and your assistants even smarter.